Sure not to set it in a sort of naturalistic Victorian setting. So I think the first decision by Sally, the director, and Katie Sykes, the designer, was kind of what's the setting going to be? And obviously Hetty runs off to the circus. So the idea was that we were going to adapt it around it being having a circus feel to it. So it's got a very, it's got an amazing set that's not in any way naturalistic, it's more like a circus rig. We all came together and read the book. And from there we decided what the important bits to pull out, and we actually improvised most of the work, while the musicians improvised a lot of the music, and from there as an ensemble we created the story of Hetty Feather for the stage. I had to learn, I hadn't done any circus skills before, so I had to learn everything for this job, in terms of all of the aerial work, silk climbing, rope climbing, hoop trapeze. We had Gwen Hales in, who is a circus instructor extraordinaire, and she did a week's training with us before we actually started the acting rehearsals, and then we had 4 weeks of sort of rehearsing the piece, but also doing intensive conditioning and circus training alongside it. And Nikki, who plays Madame Adeline, and Matt, who plays Jem and Major Botany, they're both like old school circus. So I've been really lucky to have them in the cast with me, kind of guiding me through. As soon as I got on that hoop, as soon as I got up that rope, those ropes, and as soon as I got to height, I love it. It's exhilarating and exciting, and certainly stops us from being complacent every night. One of the biggest challenges has been bringing to life one of Jacqueline's most loved characters. I think alongside sort of Tracy Beaker, Hetty has got a huge following, and is a really important character and role model to lots of children out there. So one of my biggest challenges was retaining the elements of the character that are so loved and bringing that to stage and ensuring that her fans were happy with my portrayal of Hetty. So that was quite a pressure really, and I was lucky enough to have lunch with Jacqueline and sort of talk to her about the elements of the character that she saw as the most important to bring out and bring to life on stage, and that really, really helped. So yeah, that's been a challenge, but hopefully we've risen to it. I think they should come to see the show because it really is a story for everyone. I think that, you know, often you can sort of think Jacqueline Wilson, young readers, and often particularly female, which is just not the case at all. It really is a show for everyone. And also, it's a real spectacle. It's a physical piece of theatre with loads of circus in it, hoop trapeze and amazing silk dances. And most of all, it's a story that's got a real heart, and I think it touches most of the audience members who come and see it. My favourite part has been not just bringing that character to life, which has been fantastic. She's a brilliant character to play. I've loved playing a child. That's been brilliant. That's a real challenge, but also great fun.
Madpool Jackson seized a ball of string and the biggest carving knife in the kitchen. She tied her horrid mistress up. And then...
And I love it, that's why I'm back doing it again for about 55th time. First and foremost, I'm back to my one-year-old twins and being mum and not sort of, flying around on a hoop. So first and foremost is that there are a few things in the pipeline that I've confirmed, so we'll see. Hopefully some TV again.